Yes, bonds are excellent when it comes to protective styling. But as at this point in my relaxer stretch, I dare not put my hair in a bun. Like, if I put my hair in a bun and I leave it like that for 1 week, just know that it's possible that my 7 years of hard work on my hair is gone. There is no better teacher of hair care than your hair itself. Everyone's hair is different, and your hair is going to tell you what's best for your hair. Welcome back to my channel. Here in this channel, we talk about relaxed hair care, hair growth tips, protective styling, and so much more concerning the hair topic in general. So if you know you're interested in this type of content, consider subscribing to join the family. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys 7 reasons why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers. This is not going to be one of those videos where I'm going to start telling you to condition your hair, wash your hair, moisturize your new growth and all that. Those have already been covered in several videos here on YouTube and even on my channel. What I'm going to be talking about today is a little different from the usual, so let's just get started. Now, for starters, I'm over 9 months post relaxer, and as you can see, it doesn't look like I'm struggling with my hair as at 9 months post relaxer. And at the point I'm at right now in my hair journey, I can even go on a 2 years relaxer stretch confidently without any consequences. So if I choose to relax my hair at 9 months now or at 10 months, it's because I want to and not because I'm having problems with my new growth or I can't manage my relaxer stretch or that. So now I hear so many people say that they can't even go on 5 months relaxer stretch challenges. There's nothing bad about that, okay? I'm going to talk about some of the reasons later in the video, apart from the usual moisturizing, deep conditioning and all that. These things I'm going to be talking about are key when it comes to stretching your relaxers. Now, the first reason I'm going to be talking about why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers is you've not been doing it before, okay? For example, you can't be relaxing your hair at 3 months usually and decide to go on a 6 month relaxer stretch challenge. That is not going to come out well. When I started stretching my relaxers, I did it step by step. From 3 months, I started relaxing my hair at 4 months. From 4 months, I went to 5 months. From 5 months, 6 months. From 6 months, okay, I didn't try 7 months. From 6 months, I went to 8 months. 8 months was my last relaxer stretch, and now I'm over 9 months post relaxer. So you have to do it gradually. So if you were relaxing your hair at 3 months before and you started my relaxer stretch challenge with me, please don't stay with me to 9 months or 10 months, because you won't be able to handle it because you've not been doing it before. So if you started with me at 4 months, you can relax your hair, or if you know you can go to 5 months, if you know you can get to 5 months, you can relax your hair at 5 months. Or jumping from 3 months to 6 months to 8 months to a year, it's not just feasible, okay? Because first things first, you have to give your hair the time to adjust to the new routine. Secondly, relaxer stretching is not just something you wake up and decide to do. There are things you are going to have to learn along the way from personal experience. So if the first time you are going to learn that type of lesson, you want to go on a 6 month relaxer stretch, it's not going to come out well. Routine you are going to use to stretch your relaxer for 3 months is not the same routine you are going to use to stretch your relaxer for 6 months. So that's the first reason. If you've not been doing it before, it's going to be hard. So gradually get used to the process. Transition in stretching your relaxers from a shorter duration to a longer duration. So that's it for the first reason. Now, the second reason why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers is you are not patient enough, okay? I don't know why you want to be stretching your relaxers for 6 months and you keep examining your new growth every single day. Of course, you are going to get tired, you are going to get bored, you are going to get frustrated. It will be as if you are seeing no progress. And moreover, if you feel stretching your relaxers is going to give you a faster hair growth, it's not. Your hair growth is still going to be the same. So don't get the idea that the more you stretch your relaxers, the more new growth you are going to have, like the faster your rate of growth. No guys, your hair growth rate is still going to be the same. The benefit of stretching relaxers is to prevent
breakage. That's to help in length retention, not to increase the rate of growth. Now, there's a difference between hair growth and length retention, which I'm going to talk about in another video, so make sure to stay tuned for that video. So now, here is how stretching your relaxers help in length retention, okay? The longer you stretch your relaxer, the more new growth you are going to have. Like, your rate of hair growth is going to be fixed. If your normal rate is half an inch per month, let's say if we're relaxing your hair at 3 months before, in 3 months you're going to have 1.5 inch, meaning you are going to have to relax just 1.5 inch, and with that there is a higher probability of you relaxing previously relaxed hair compared to when you have a lot of new growth. For example, when you go on a 6 month relaxer stretch and you now have 3 inches of new growth, there is a lot of room for you to work with when applying the relaxers. So there is less tendency for you to relax previously relaxed, because relaxing your previously relaxed is going to lead to over processing. You may not see the effect immediately the day you relax, but when you over process your hair becomes more weakened, more prone to breakage. So as time goes by, your hair will be more likely to break compared to when it's not over processed, it's stronger and all that. So the effect of over processing happens over time. Like, you're not going to see the effect that day, because normally the longer your hair grows, the more your ends become weak. Like, the ends of your hair are weak compared to the new growth. So why not just allow it to go through its natural weakness instead of you adding salt to injury by over processing the hair, like making it so weak when it's still close to the scalp level. It means that before it gets to your shoulder, it's already off. So coming back to the second tip, be patient. And I know, yeah, sometimes it's not easy locking away our hair like that for so long. Me myself, I so desperately want to relax my hair right now. If you've been following me, you know this. I love the feel, the look of freshly relaxed hair. But I just have to discipline myself, because in the long run, the benefits I'm going to get from this will be worth it. So you have to be patient with the relaxer process. If you tell yourself, this time around, I'm going on a 6 month relaxer stretch, just remove your mind. Like, just find a way to distract yourself, because the more you keep thinking about your hair, thinking, fantasizing about it, wishing that you could relax it now, you may eventually find out that you relaxed your hair before this 6 months. So be patient with the relaxer process. If you say, I'm going to relax my hair at 6 months this time around, patiently wait for that 6 months to come and go. All right, don't rush it. Now, the third reason why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers is because you don't have a goal. All right, with every relaxer stretch, you should have a goal, not just for the purpose of stretching your relaxer. I have a goal for every of my relaxer stretches. With my last relaxer stretch, I actually met my goal. I was at waist length before I started that relaxer stretch, which lasted for 8 months. And before I started the relaxer stretch, I made up my mind, okay, the goal I want to get from this relaxer stretch is to get to hip length. And if you've been following me, you saw that after that 8 months relaxer stretch, I went from waist length to hip length. So have a goal. You know, when you have a goal in mind, you have something to look forward to, you have a motivation and inspiration, you finally find yourself becoming more disciplined, more motivated, more patient and all that. And with this relaxer stretch challenge I'm currently on, I have a goal. So I was at hip length after that relaxer stretch, and I decided to go on another relaxer stretch to take me from hip length to tailbone length. So my current goal for this relaxer stretch is tailbone length. I'm currently 9 months in this relaxer stretch and still counting. So fingers crossed I get to my goal. So you have to get a goal, because when you don't have a goal, anything comes and goes. Because if you were supposed to stretch your hair for, let's say, 5 months and it gets to 3 months and you just feel like relaxing your hair, like you're tired of waiting, when you don't have a goal, you find yourself easily relaxing your hair, because there's nothing to look forward to, there's nothing to push you, there's no motivation, there's no inspiration, nothing, no goal, no reason for you to continue that relaxer stretch. So have a goal. Don't stretch your relaxers just for the purpose of stretching your relaxer. Now, don't just say my goal is for my hair to be longer than the way it was. That is not a goal. Everyone wishes for long hair. Set specific goal. If you are currently at shoulder length, you can say that this next relaxer stretch I want to embark on, I wish that it takes me from shoulder length to bra strap length. Set specific goals. You can even use inches. You can say, with this relaxer stretch, I want to see 3 more inches in length retention. Set specific goal. You know, when you have a goal, you have a pushing force. You suddenly see that stretching and relaxing has become easy because you are motivated, and when you have a goal, you kind of find ways, especially when you are serious with your goals, you kind of find ways to achieve that goal. So always make sure you have goals when stretching your relaxers. Now the next reason I'm going to be talking about, I think this is number four, why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers, is you don't pay attention to your ends. When stretching your relaxers, you shouldn't pay attention to only your new growth, because if you pay attention to only your new growth and you neglect your ends, in fact your head is going to come out shorter than when you started that relaxer stretch challenge. Because some of us complain like, relaxer stretch is not just my thing, after going on this relaxer stretch my head came out shorter, I had a lot of breakage when I went on this relaxer stretch, my ends became more damaged after this relaxer stretch, my ends were split, and then you decided not to go on a relaxer stretch again, not knowing that the reason why that happened was because you actually neglected your ends. In fact, I always say this, your ends are the most important thing when it comes to retaining length, because breakage occurs at the ends, not at the new growth. The new growth is strong enough to go another couple of years before it becomes weak and starts breaking up, but your ends are fragile. So pay special attention to your ends. Just because you are stretching your relaxers does not mean your ends suddenly become useless. In fact, your ends are the most important at this point, because the reason why you are stretching your relaxer is actually to see length retention, right? And what better way to see length retention than to take care of your ends? Apart from the ends, another point of breakage is the point of transition between the new growth and the previously relaxed hair. Now, this is a major problem for most of us, if not all of us, and that is why to take care of this altogether, protect my ends, protect the point of transition between the new growth and the previously relaxed hair, my hair is always in protective styles when I'm stretching my relaxer. If you don't see me in a protective style, no, I'm not stretching my relaxer at that point. There is never a time I'm stretching my relaxer and my hair is not in protective style, because now at this point my ends are protected, the point of transition between the new growth and my previously relaxed hair is protected, because now my point of transition should be somewhere here at this moment. Now since it's in a protective style, tell me how it's going to get tangled, tell me how it's going to break, tell me how I'm going to over manipulate it, how I'm going to comb it and it starts breaking. So always make sure you find a way of protecting your hair, protecting your ends, even when stretching your relaxers. Now this brings me to the next reason why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers, and that is you over manipulate your hair. How can you be stretching your relaxers and you are combing your hair every day? Like, how do you even have the strength to do that? Because me, I know the struggle I go through every time I want to detangle my new growth or comb my new growth, and it's hell. I don't know how you can be stretching your relaxers and go through that every day. For me, I can't. I don't even have the strength for that, okay? And that is a form of over manipulation. Now, I said the point of transition between your new growth and your previously relaxed hair is very, very prone to breakage. Now, the more you over manipulate your hair, the more you are going to see breakage. And this is even worse, because this is not going to be breakage at the ends of your hair. If it's breakage at the ends of your hair, okay, let's say your ends are gone, but you still have, you know, some length. But if the breakage occurs at the point of transition between your new growth and your previously relaxed hair, it means the hair you are going to be losing will be long, like long strands, meaning you are going to lose not just hair, but you are going to lose density as well. If you're someone that has low density hair, this is even going to be worse, because I don't know how the hair is going to come out after this. So find a way for you to stop manipulating your hair excessively when you are stretching your relaxers, and like I said, protective styling is my best way to avoid over manipulating my hair when I'm stretching my relaxers. Now this brings me to the next reason, I think this is number six, which is you don't choose the right protective styles. Not every protective style is right for stretching your relaxers. Yes, bonds are excellent when it comes to protective styling, but as at this point in my relaxer stretch, I dare not put my hair in the bond. Like, if I put my hair in a bond and I leave it like that for 1 week, just know that it's possible that my 7 years of hard work on my hair is gone. because the way my hair is going to come out, it's going to be disastrous. So choose the right protective style. Choose a protective style that will protect your ends and at the same time the point of transition between your new growth and your previously relaxed hair. Because when stretching your relaxers, bones will take off your ends, but they will not take care of that point of transition. Okay, it's still exposed, they are still free to collide and move against each other, especially when you are sleeping. So find a way to choose the right protective style for your hair. I recommend box braid, twist, cornrows, sew-ins, false locks. If you can do African threading, it's an excellent method of protective styling. You know, when I first started my hair journey, that was what I started with. And guys, if you've not done African threading, you've not seen pain when it comes to installing protective styles, okay? So if you can do that, beautiful. But if not, you can do the other protective styles. And if you can do these styles without extensions, it's great as well. There are currently no extensions added to my hair. This is just my hair. So yeah, my hair is in braids, but I'm currently using wigs as a method of protective styling. So wigs are also great when it comes to you protecting your hair. I already made a video on my experience with wigs, like a little review about the use of wigs so far, and I think that was my last video, so you can check it out if you are interested. So always use the right protective style when stretching your relaxers, and don't even think of stretching your relaxer without your protective style, because me, I think it will be very, very hard to stretch your relaxers without a protective style. But I know some people do it though, like stretching their relaxers without using protective styles, but I think this will be very, very difficult, especially if you have high density hair, if you have coarse, if you have very curly hair. Because me, I retain a lot of texture in my hair even when I'm relaxed. So putting my hair down, not in a protective style, while stretching my relaxer, it's not even feasible to me. Like, it's not possible. So everyone has what works for them, so listen to your hair. And besides, when you are not in a protective style, the more you're going to manipulate your hair, because when your hair is down, you are going to need to detangle your hair. So you may be thinking, okay, what if I don't use a comb on my hair and just finger detangle my hair? It's still a form of manipulation, even if you are just finger detangling your hair. Rubbing your fingers through your hair every day is still a form of manipulation. So it will actually be easier stretching your relaxers with protective styles than not using a protective style. Now, the seventh reason I'm going to be talking about why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers is you don't tell your hair problems to the right people. You tell your hair problems to the wrong people. You can't decide to stretch your relaxers for 6 months and start seeking advice from someone that stretches her relaxers for 3 months. Like, what kind of advice do you expect the person to give you? The person is going to give you advice that helped her stretch her hair to 3 months. So if you are looking for tips on how to stretch your relaxers for 6 months, you're going to have to look for someone that have gone on a 6 month relaxer stretch or longer than that. So make sure you tell your hair problems to the wrong people. When you want to stretch your relaxers, don't even think about going to someone that does not believe in stretching relaxers to seek for advice, because that one, you're just going to talk you out of your whole plan and everything. Because, you know, friends and people around us have a way of influencing our decisions and all that. So when you go and seek advice from that type of person, before you know, you start thinking the same way that stretching your relaxers is even a no-go area. I know I'm digressing a little at this point, but you know, when it comes to people that don't agree with your hair opinions, your hair beliefs and all that, there is no point trying to argue with them. The thing is, action speaks louder than words in every aspect, even in your hair journey. So instead of arguing with words, why not argue with actions? Now, for example, if you and a friend have different opinions about stretching your relaxers, you don't have to argue with words. All you have to do is go stretch your relaxers, and after the end of the relaxer stretch, when you probably get from shoulder length to waist length and you come and meet the friend, you know that friend will be asking you, hey, how did you do it? What happened? Show me the secret. What product did you use? Now, at that point, you will not be in an argument, you will be teaching them instead. So just chill out, okay? There is no point arguing with people that don't agree with your hair opinion. opinions, all right? Agrees with your actions. So that's why you have to put in work with your head, because it will not make sense for you to now stretch your relaxer, come back, and you are still at the same length. You know that friend is going to be like, you see, I told you that you were just wasting your time stretching this relaxer. So that's why you have to build your skills when it comes to hair knowledge and all that. There's nothing in this world that you want to do and succeed in without knowledge. So you have to research. Even if you don't read books, watching videos like this actually mean you are on point. Watch YouTube videos, you can go on Instagram, look for hair tips, and most importantly, listen to your hair, because there is no better teacher of hair care than your hair itself. Everyone's hair is different and your hair is going to tell you what's best for your hair. So when you know you want to stretch your relaxers, don't go seeking advice from people that have different opinions on relaxer stretches, so people that have not stretched their relaxers as long as you have stretched your relaxers. Even if the person has a longer hair length as yours, the fact is the person has not stretch her relaxers for 6 months and she can't give you advice to stretch your relaxer for 6 months. The person may have been stretching her relaxers for 3 months to get to that length of hair, but may have gotten that length not from relaxer stretching but from another routine or regimen to supplement the fact that she was relaxing her hair at 3 months interval instead of stretching for a longer period of time. So when you meet that kind of person to help you stretch your relaxers, the person is going to give you things that helped her stretch her relaxers for 3 months without adding the regimen or routine that supplemented that 3 months relaxer stretch to get her hair longer. The only way you can know this is if you dive for that and ask, because if you just go there and ask for relaxer stretch, the person is just going to tell you about relaxer stretch. So if you want to stretch your relaxer for 10 months, go and seek advice from someone that has stretched her relaxers for 10 months or someone that has stretched her relaxers longer than that. So yeah guys, these are the 7 reasons I have for you right now why it's hard for you to stretch your relaxers. If you have any reason that has made stretching your relaxers hard, you can leave it down in the comment section down below. Or if I can come up with other reasons, I'm going to make a part 2 of this video. So if you watched this video this far and you enjoyed it, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you are new here and you aren't subscribed, I don't know why you have watched the video to this point and you have still not hit that subscribe button. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button because it is free. You aren't going to pay a dime. So hit it. Turn the post notification bell so that you become the first to get notified whenever I upload a new video. So yeah guys, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching and see you in my next video. Bye.